Have you ever felt like you were living according to someone else's rules? Maybe another way to put that is, do you ever feel like you are bound to meet the expectations that others have for you? Or maybe you're one of these people that have lived by the rules your whole life, and those rules are collective rules, right? You've lived by the rules, done what you've been expected to do your whole life, and now you look around and you notice that you're tired and that you're just not as happy as you thought you would be by following the rules. And then there's this little voice in your head that says, you know what? What does it matter anyway? Happiness is just a fleeting emotion. I may be happy for a moment, but then it's going to go away and I'm going to be stuck with this misery anyway. Happiness is not worth the pursuit. And yet there's that little voice of your soul that is still there and will always be there. And that little voice of your soul knows that you are whole, that you are complete, and that you are perfect just as you are right now. And that part of you longs for you to experience your wholeness, your completeness, and your perfectness, even when you're flawed. So the question is, are you going to go with the voice of your head that says it's not worth it anyway? Or are you going to lean into the message of your soul that says this is who you are? You are whole, you are complete, and you are perfect. But how do we do this? How do we become aware of the stories that we are living by? Here is a common scenario. So let's say that you had a relationship with someone in your past. Maybe it's a friend from high school or college or a job that you had at some point. And at that time, the two of you were close. You shared things together. You grew together. You were there for one another. And yet over time, that faded. And now you haven't heard from this person in several weeks, months, maybe even years. That is the scenario. So now let's decide how we want to make meaning of that. So in this first scenario, let's say that the meaning that we give is in the story of why am I always the one who has to reach out first? That is an indication that there is a story, right? So that question, why am I always the one who has to do this first, is going to generate emotions. And if I were in this case, that those emotions would be irritation, agitation, frustration, just pissed off. Like, why am I always the one? And then it goes to actions. What am I going to choose to do? And this is kind of where I feel stuck sometimes in these relationships. Do I want to be the person who is always going above and beyond and reaching out and trying to connect with someone? Or am I going to take a passive aggressive approach and say, hey, you know, they lived without me this long. I wonder how long they're willing to continue to live without me. Those are some of the decisions and stories that would go with that story of why am I always the one who has to make the first move? And then you can imagine the results that may or may not come from that storyline, that those emotions and those actions. So now let's clear the screen and let's go back to the objective data, which is there is no longer an active relationship here. So instead of saying, why am I? Why does this have something to do with me? The question is, I wonder what has happened to them. I wonder what they are going through that keeps them from continuing to engage in the way that we had in the past. Is there a promotion that they are attempting to meet new responsibilities? Is someone in their family or in their close circle, someone who's gotten sick or someone who's gotten hurt, or maybe they've been diagnosed with some sort of illness, or maybe they've had some sort of an accident that they are healing from? And maybe there are layers of hurt that they are not even aware of yet. Any of these things could be interfering with their abilities to receive the efforts on your part to connect with them. Now, you may have already noticed that in that first scenario of why do I, it's really about why me. And those questions are rooted in a sense of lack. On the other hand, when we get curious about what is happening for or to that other person, we can now move into a state of compassion and grace. And it's from that state then that we get to choose what actions we will proceed with. Now, the point is, there's no right or wrong answer here about what you do. This is all going back to who do you want to be? This is about deciding who you want to be in this relationship, even if the other person never chooses to engage with you again. You may choose to reconnect with them from this state of compassion or grace, or you may choose to let them go with no judgment and no strings attached. In either of these options, the outcome is open-ended. You can show up as you are without expectations for how they might respond to you. This is a common scenario that illustrates a very powerful question. And that question is, who do you choose to be? In any challenging situation you find yourself in, ask yourself, who do I choose to be right here, right now? Will you choose to continue to live by the rules of codependency or trauma survival that you've been living with? Or will you be willing to let go of the expectations of others and your own self-imposed limitations that you use to keep yourself feeling safe? Your experience is always a direct result of the meaning that you give to what is happening around you. The meaning that you give is always determined by the unconscious stories that you are living by. You now know that you have the power to make these unconscious stories conscious so that you can update them based on who you are now and who you want to become in the future.